Hi there, folks. Rob Helean with your Asian session preview for Wednesday, the 14th of September 2011. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Please be advised the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. It is not an alert service. Coaches will not make trade recommendations. However, we will conduct technical and fundamental analysis of the live markets and help you construct trade plans throughout the course of the trading day. Now, please bear in mind when trading heavily leveraged, it's a very risky business. Also, your past performance does not predict your future results, and please do not trade the money, guys, that you cannot afford to part ways with. Take a look at the, let's just run through some fractals on the euro for today, guys, and see if we can work out where we're at and see what sort of trade plans we could potentially make. Now, since we've, I'm going to highlight a box in yellow. I've been talking about this at FX Street and in my Bootcamp Asia class, but this sort of yellow area through here was primarily our summer. And as you can see, rather sideways, rather difficult trading conditions, and of course, I don't believe no surprise. And since that period, we've had some fundamentals come out in the market, and we've got this clear sort of fresh direction towards USD strength. And that's sort of, I think, the way that fundamentals are still pointing. Well, they haven't changed, have they, to support USD weakness as such. And there's nothing maybe really out there I couldn't see seriously on the horizon either. So maybe we could make an assumption that longer term that this sort of direction is what's in control, and that's therefore what we should be looking to trade. So that to me is fine. My long-term bias for now, I think, is fairly down, and there is no doubt about it. We've broken some significant lows on this euro, and I believe we could be continuing. Even that yellow area, it could be a roll reversal, and we could continue to the downside. And I'm completely open to that. The only issue I've got now is, to me, it seriously looks like we're trying to change trend on the 4-hour chart to the long side here. This euro is trying its level best to me to want to do something along these lines. Very fast swinging down here, end of last week. Pull back on Monday, could not break fresh lows after New York on Tuesday, and looks like to me we want to sort of do something like that before we maybe look at doing that. This is the way the fractal nature of the market works. In this yellow area here, definitely gone, haven't we, from very quite fast riding the 4-hour five down here for a couple of days to halt, stop, sort of sideways action. Let's just check it out on maybe an hourly chart. Yeah, this is this week so far in here. Let's get my blue arrow. And fairly average trading conditions. I haven't traded the euro as such. I'm waiting for a break of this little range we're in here, or this little wedge, upside wedge we're forming, and then I will kindly make a trade. So my trade plans are actually along these lines, guys. Is I'm quite open that we can actually sort of solidly break this range and actually swing up for another day or two. 138, 139. That would be completely fine with me. That would be like a nice big fib of this fall, something like that. But if we get long, I'm going to try and hold that as long as possible, guys, just for the off chance that maybe, like we saw up here when we rolled over up in this area up here, obviously we just got a 4-hour change of trend, technical change happen, okay? And we were heading up, and then fundamentals crept in, and boom, off we go. So what I always do on a 4-hour change of trend these days, guys, is I will take the shorter term long here. I know it's longer term resistance, okay? But what if we did do this for a couple of days and you were long it, and then suddenly USD weakness fundamentals came out in the market and we just got that? Sort of thing that you can, once you get into trade, you can trail your stop manually and see if you can get lucky. Quite often you're going to find that you're going to get on the right side of some fundamentals and you're actually going to go ride that for like, a few days, even a week, and it's sort of against the larger scale trend. And then when you finally do roll over on, say, a 4-hour back up in some high level, Then you just climb back on the clue train to the short side and take the 4 hour sort of change of trend and short it, and we're all good in the hood. So going back to the trade plans for the day, I'm going to wait for this wedge to get broken in either direction, and then I'm going to look to trade it in that direction. If we come down here today and break this sort of bottom, then I'll kindly take that and just continue to ride that down to the downside. The longer term trend is down. There is nothing wrong with this going sideways, catching up with a, say, a daily five, and then just falling through the floor. And I'll just ride that momentum and maybe look for 135, 134. I'd be totally cool with that. But I would totally be cool with a clear break of here, pull back long, and see if I can get lucky up to, say, 138, 139, and just try and ride that for as long as humanly possible. Okay, there would be nothing, you know, we're long right now. We've been long for the last half a day on this piece. Check it out on the 15-minute chart. And so, you know, the sort of short-term bulls are sort of in control of this market right now. If I saw that, guys, I'd probably take a little shot there and to see how long I can run that up for. Okay? The risk that I've been explaining in my FX Street classes is if you don't take something like that and you like to sit in front of the computer all day and you don't therefore get in a trade, sometimes psychologically it can be a little bit damaging to you, the fact that you're not actually making pips. And that's when rules get broken, trading rules, and that's when you start taking trades you shouldn't. So I like to have little strategies for every sort of little scenario I'm looking at. I think we're sort of sideways here. We're forming an upside wedge. If we can break that further to the upside. In fact, this break here, if I was in front of my computer, you know, that long is actually not that bad. We did break these highs through here. You know, maybe we're going to get long from here. So if you have taken a long recently in the last few hours, you might be looking fairly okay. So we'll run it up the flagpole there and we'll see what happens. Likewise, if we come and break the lows, you know, that sort of deal. And hopefully something's going to stick. I'll keep you updated how it's going to go. FX Street tonight is going to be talking about testing your trading strategies and systems. And we're going to talk a little Forex tester and little methodologies that I use to fast track my way there. Okay, look forward to seeing you at FX Street. I'll put the registration link in the text of this video. Have yourselves a good trading day, guys, and we'll catch you later in the week. Cheers.